Yeah, I talk about another game of MLB Road to the Show 19 on the PS4, guys. Here we go. Hope we have a really good game in AAA.
The evaluation of minor league prospects is not only the business of team scouts. Sports agents do their homework as well.
Edward, this is John Kent of 989 Sports Management. We're big fans of your potential and would like to help you achieve your goal. How can you do that? Perhaps you can give me your pitch to my advice. I already have someone representing me.
From the ranks of hundreds of minor league prospects, the next generation of MLB superstars will eventually emerge.
Your high school coach has been advised you right. We'll actually speak briefly just after you were drafted. Would it be okay if you gave him a call tomorrow?
Determining which prospects will be those superstars is big business.
We have a lot of resources, most importantly, relationships with the front office of every team. When you have a demand of a contract to negotiate, we will help you get there. Makes sense.
And getting in on the ground floor is smart business.
No pressure, Edward. Tell you what, I'll give him my pitch and the two of you can talk it over. If you decide you are ready, we will drive to take you on. Okay, let's go to bullpen practice because we really need to work on... work on this. This sinker really needs to be worked on.
This prospect has become the object of a notable sports management company's attention.
Edward, I spoke with John Kennedy, sports management. He made a good pitch, and the fact is, I do think the time is coming when you will need more from a representative than I can offer. But what do we know about this guy and his company? I trust your judgment, and I'll...
However impressive an agent's qualifications may be, the trading in of a long-time trusted mentor for a corporate wheeler-dealer scary step.
You know, I wouldn't mess around with your future, Edward. I've vested this company and I think they're a great fit for you if you feel like you're ready. And you're fully confident in this guy? This time seems right. Let's give it a go.
But a fledgling must leave the nest for a big world awaits.
I'll tell him you're in. It's been such a pleasure helping bring you along to this point. Edward, I just can't wait to see all you're going to do in this game. Clubhouse, let's go ahead and talk with this guy. He's just feeling great about this recent hitting performance. You've been on a tear lately. Keep it up, and it's been a big help to the team. Hess tells you that he's just doing what it takes to help out the team.
A manager checks in with his ball club.
I told that the Athletics have a scout coming to take a look at us sometime during this homestand. And there's talk it would be the director of scouting himself. Let's get in some extra work so you'll be ready to impress. 20 chances. That's good. Man, I really want to work on the fastball. Last one. You're pretty good on practice.
Conversation with a new representative can be exhilarating to a young player.
I'm so happy you decided to go with us. We think the sky is the limit for you. Now tell me, how are you feeling about your situation with the athletics organization? Could be better, I guess. No complaints. Pretty happy with everything right now. Could be better, I guess.
A savvy agent will engender confidence in his client. Confidence that he has a world of possibilities at his fingertips.
It's my job to help you get what you want, Edward. Tell me anything that isn't ideal anytime, and we can look at how we might work to change going forward. I just never saw myself with the athletics at all. I have ideas about what role I want, but I'm not sure they care. Okay, but for now, I'm good. I just don't see myself as an athletic.
How well he can turn these possibilities into actuality.
We can get you where you want to go. We'll need to be patient, though. We have no leverage right now, but things can happen, and we'll have choices down the road. Mark McKenna?
What?
Chad Pinder? Those are two major leaguers.
What?
Welcome to MLB The Show and this presentation of Minor League Baseball. Tonight, the opener of a three-game series between the Round Rock Express and the Las Vegas Aviators. It's baseball, it's The Show, and it comes your way next. Ace Lyles gets the call for game one of the series. Dan Plesac, what do you got?
Hey, Matt, this guy keeps his team in the ballgame. He's won two of his last three starts, so he's been throwing the ball really well. And one of the keys for this guy is getting early outs to keep his pitch count down. If he can do that, he should be able to get into the seventh or eighth inning in this one here today.
First delivery to him on the way. First of three here on this Tuesday night as the game's first offering is taken for strike one. Fellas are home nine as they begin play here this evening. They begin this series feeling pretty good about the way things have gone as they come in right in a four-game winning streak.
Yeah, Matty. Dan, this team is playing well. They're getting closer in the division race. I guess my question to you, I want to ask you, did you find that you started to really pitch better as the summer months started to get hotter?
No doubt about it. Not only does the team start feeling better, but I think you get a good five starts going throughout the clubhouse. You realize that the schedule is starting to wind itself down. Every game is more important. The bigger the game, hopefully the better you play. And this team's been playing some really good baseball lately.
Time now to give you a look at the batting order for the visiting squad. Mark DeRosa, what do they have to do to get the season off to a good start on the road?
Yeah, Matty, every person that bought a ticket tonight came to see one thing, and that's the guy on the mound. But I'll tell you what, from an offensive standpoint, this is what you live for. Who's going to make the adjustments offensively to put quality at-bats against this guy? Do they have to get him early? Can someone work themselves into a big count to drive a ball in the gap late? I am so fired up to see this offense take on this monster.
Good deception on the slider there as he's way out in front.
Looped under that one with that swing, which tells me he was probably anticipating it being a sinker.
Fastball, strike three called as he couldn't pull the trigger, and there are two away. Now at the plate, Guillermo Salas. And there's a look at his home and road splits so far this year. Swung on and lifted in the air to left center. Kenna giving chase. He gets there to make the catch, and that ends the inning. Nothing doing here in the opening half inning. So it's on to the bottom of inning number one. No. Digging in, Kyle Tucker. He'll start things out in the top half of the second.
The designated hitter.
Pulled toward right center field. Calling for it, Kenna. One down.
Wait a minute, I think this is the Astros we're pulling.
All right, here's how the home side's lining up defensively. And if you look at the numbers on this team, defensively, they're in the top five fewest errors in the league. Flashing the leather, picking and grinning, keeping up. They play stout defense.
Fielded cleanly, and he'll step on first himself for the out. So coming to the plate, Daryl McMillan, he'll get to take his first cuts here. No contact on the sinker there, and he's behind 0-1.
Oh, I just don't understand that swing. The first two guys made outs on just one pitch? What are they doing up there?
Zapata is underneath this one, and that will retire the side. Nothing across here this half of the inning. We'll go to the bottom half of inning number two. Vegas holds the aces. They lead it. Leading off the inning, Sean Fabregas, and they'll need him to get something going here. First pitch of the inning is taken low and away for a ball. It's 1-0. Ball and a strike.
Hey, we got no out.
It's 1-2. Skied into straightaway right. Hopper is there.
My.
And that's the first out of the inning. Into the box, Carlo Hernandez, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Low for ball one. Good fastball as he gets the swing and a miss.
Just reached back and threw a high fastball right by him. He didn't stand a chance.
Easy take there on the sinker, well off the outside. Bases are empty, one man out.
That was a good located fastball upstairs.
So 2-2 now.
Might have been been cheating for another fastball, trying to get the head to that one early. Pitcher pulled the string with a nasty breaking ball, had him a little bit out in front.
Now a swing and a miss here as he's down on strikes, so it's two up, two down to begin the third.
Batting done. The second baseman.
And there's his strike right down the heart of the plate, 0-1. Sent back up the middle to his right, Dietrich. And oh, the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he'll reach it first.
And as a former pitcher, I can tell you, nothing is more painful than having to get extra outs in an inning. That should have been out number three there. Instead, he has to refocus and get back to
Dang.
Work.
I was trying to
into
be
the
there
box,
on time.
Miles Straw to the left side, but it's well foul. 0-1 here in the early going. Too high.
Oh, come on.
Wow, that's a tough pitch to take. 0-2 fastball just off the corner, and I mean just off the corner.
Lofted in the air out toward right center. Calling for it, Hopper. And the inning is over. So no runs on no hits. One error. Leading off the inning, Andre Beverly, as they'll look to get something going here and even this game up. And that one's in on the hands to start the inning. It's ball one. Slow roller down the third baseline, but a foul ball, 1-1. On the ground down the first baseline, reined in. Oh, look at the sliding stop. He is out. And that's a huge play to keep the leadoff man off base. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Sinker to open the AB in there for strike one. That's in there. And he's deep in the hole now, 0-2.
You know, it's great to be patient, make a pitcher work and all that stuff to try to get walks, but you have to be ready to hit. And that was a really hittable pitch. And now you've got to deal with an 0-2 count.
And he fouls this one off. The 1-2. A swing and a ground ball to third. He's got to hurry. And that's the second out. Next will be the designated hitter, Kyle Tucker. He flew out in his last at bat. Swing and a miss on the slider. Nothing and one. Hit in the air down the right field line. Hopper on the move. He tracks it down, and that will end the inning. So
really nothing
in,
for us
Enrique
now.
Colon, he got on top of one and was a ground out victim last time. And that misses inside 1-0. Count even now at 1-1. The 1-2. That's a base hit, their first of the game.
Boy, Dero, the game of baseball has changed. There's so much velocity in the game. That was a 96-mile-an-hour fastball that he smoked the other way.
Yeah, you have to keep your front shoulder tough right there. You have to honor. When a guy's throwing that hard, 96 miles an hour, you have to honor that fastball and try and work it the other way to keep you on the off speed.
Count moves to a ball and two strikes now. Colon on at first, nobody out. Fastball swung on and missed for the first out.
Now batting, the left fielder.
This is the situation where there's a lot of pressure on the infielders if the ball is put in play on the ground. Both the guy at first and at the plate are burners, so a double play is going to be tough. Even getting one out could be a challenge.
Another one sent foul.
Yeah.
Now a throw over to first, and he's back standing. Runners on first with one down. Good bite to that sinker as he gets him to swing through it for route number two. That's back-to-back strikeouts now as they've been unable to advance that leadoff single into scoring position.
Yeah, clearly no problems working up the stretch right now, man. He's taking control this inning after giving up that hit. Now we'll see if he can finish it off strong as well.
1-1 the count. Into center field, line drive, base hit. At the plate, Lorne Assuncion. He's 0-1 thus far.
The second base.
Swing and a miss on the sinker, 0-1.
Assuncion.
Two down, runners at first and second. Fastball taken, but that gets the zone for a strike. Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning.
92.
So it's no runs on two hits, no errors, and two men left stranded. Home half of the fifth coming up.
Yay, we scored again.
Riding in, Miles Straw. He'll start things out in the sixth for a lineup that really hasn't found its groove in this one.
Yeah, only two hits so far, Matt, and not very many hard hit balls either. We'll see if they can start making some adjustments.
Well, obviously, somebody was hooting with the Owls last night. This entire roster, they've showed up for the first game of this road trip and are getting absolutely boat raced.
Stays alive, still 0-2. Swing and a miss as he ran the fastball right by him for the first down.
He's been in total control out there tonight. Gets the leadoff guy with a strike out there, and it just seems like we've seen so many off-balance swings and weakly hit balls in this one.
How about it? The third baseman, Andre.
Drops in a strike to start the at-bat. Nothing and one. Fouled off. One out, nobody on. Lays off that time, and it's 1-2.
1-2.
One out now, one out.
And a fastball swung on and missed as they set him down for the second time here tonight.
Pretty impressive back-to-back strikeouts to start the inning. What's even more important is now he gets to face the middle of the order without anybody on base for them to drive in.
Into the box now, Guillermo Salas. He'll swing and lift the ball fouled off to the left and out of play. He's 0-2 in the ballgame so far. Called strike on the outside part of the plate, 0-2.
Hey, you can tell by the look on that manager's face, he's obviously frustrated right now.
And we'll have to leave it there as this is strike three, and that will retire the side. Pretty painless half of the inning, all told.
Enough energy to pitch the
next
seventh
will be
inning.
Cleanup hitter Kyle Tucker, 0-2. He's flown out twice. And the first pitch of the inning here misses down and in for a ball. That's 1-0. Pulled hard, but it's foul down the first base side. From the windup, the 1-1 pitch. Popped him up. Saldana over to his right. And he hauls it in for the first out of the inning.
There we go.
Digging in once again, Enrique Colon. He singled his last time up. Here's a sinker to start him out, but he wouldn't bite. It's ball one. Bases are empty, one man out. No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike.
Hey, we got one.
Turned on that one and crushed it. Just pulled it a little foul. Here now the 2-2. Freezes him. A strikeout looking.
He's just ringing up strikeouts left and right. But what's really impressive to me, he hasn't walked anyone either. He's just pounding the zone. He's starting dirty today.
Hits the bottom of the strike zone here with the sinker. Strike one.
Oh and two.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch. Slider. Good two-strike pitch, but it misses 1-2.
And he got will him. Strike him out. 10 now in the ball game, and the inning is over.
Oh wow, they're keeping me up there.
They'll
need him to get something going here. To his right, Barry.
Beautiful sinker.
Throw on to first in time, so the leadoff man is set down to open up inning number 8. Now with the play, Carlo Hernandez.
The first base, number 17.
Pops this one up. Barry has a play.
I got it.
He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. Now with the plate,
my guy was getting tired. I'm
down to their final four outs here, Dan.
Yeah, it's not looking too good for them right now, Matt. They've got a significant hill to climb, but they've got to take it one bat at a time. A couple of guys get on, and then who knows what could happen.
High in the air, down the right field line.
Yes! He caught it. He makes the catch.
He caught it? Maybe that's a good rookie right there, then.
Okay, I'm done.
No?
Yeah.
You are.
For these guys, the White Sox stretches their winning streak to 5, and they're playing well in all three phases of the game. Pitching,
the Oakland Athletics win this.
Who knows how long this will last?
4-0 to score tonight. Las Vegas jumped out to an early lead in the first and never looked back. Ace Lyles earns his first win of the season as he racked up 10 strikeouts in the effort. So that just about does it for Mark.
I did better at my second appearance in Triple A.
For more, make your way on over to show19.com.
All right, Astros.
I heard the Oakland Athletics.
And music. Disco music. Doing top 10.
Here now is our final line score. Bird for your...
This AAA player has been...
Edward, you've been tearing up the Pacific Coast League. What's your response to spectating that Athletics should call you up? I trust Athletics to call me up when I'm ready.
Captain.
Excellence commands.
Why do you think you haven't gotten the call yet? Good question. Ask them that. Who knows? Maybe they don't have my number. I know they have their reasons, but my time will come.
And an invitation to the...
Thanks, Edwards. Keep it up, and I'm sure it wouldn't be too long.
I'm a show tonight too, double A. The one? Build yourself for the muscles. I'm 21 of these. Four seamer, two seamer.
No, I think I'll go back in the bullpen again. I need to work on that one.
Hey, which one's in the book?
A player receives a check-in from one of his coaches.
No matter how confident you get, there's always some aspect of your game that you can challenge yourself to improve. Two-time performance gain activity active. Okay. Strikeouts.
Oh, that was arrival.
Let's see. Sarah sent some banner ahead of the game. All you have is talk. We have the record to back it up. Zep tells you it doesn't matter how you feel. Better team will win. First win in AAA.
MLB The Show's tour of the minor leagues continues as we make a stop in the Ace Lyles gets the ball in game 3 of the series. Dan, any thoughts?
Hey, it wasn't a great performance in his last start, but he did pitch well enough to earn the win. We'll see if he can turn in a little bit better performance in this one.
Standing in, Domingo Zepeda. And we are ready for some daytime baseball. This one over toward first. And he'll take this to the bag himself, and there's your first out of the ballgame. And now we'll look at the starting lineup for the visitors in this one. D-Ro, daytime road game for him. What you got?
Yeah, Matty, it's going to be interesting how this offense goes about it. Are they going to go after him early? Are they going to sit back and take, hope he doesn't have his secondary stuff, and drive his pitch count up? You have to find ways. You can't just throw your bats out on the field and think you're going to score runs off a premier guy.
Fellas, you take a look at the home side here as they take the field this afternoon. They're on a great run of late as they come in winners of 7 of their last 9 games.
Yeah, Matty. Dan, this team is playing well. They're getting closer in the division race. I guess my question to you, I want to ask you, did you find that you started to really pitch better as the summer months started to get hotter?
No doubt about it. Not only does the team start feeling better, but I think you get a good vibe starting to go throughout the clubhouse. You realize that the schedule is starting to wind itself down. Every game is more important. The bigger the game, hopefully the better you play. And this team's been playing some really good baseball lately.
Now a fastball gets the upper part of the zone for strike two.
I guess he's really trying to measure that fastball in his first at bat, but you really never want to put yourself in 0-2 count if you could do anything about it.
Strike three called, and the inning is over. So a rather pedestrian start to the top half. So striding forward now, number 12. First shot for him here. 2 hits in 5 trips a night ago.
Number 12.
The windup and the 0-1. And it's 1-1. The 1-2. Is a wave and a miss. He struck him out.
Okay, here's the defense for the home team. And guys, I want you to think back to our pregame meeting with the manager before this one. The one thing he kept preaching to us is that they got to play better defense. Coming off last game, they made 3 errors in that one. They're going to have to clean it up and give themselves a better chance to win this game on the defensive side of the ball.
The windup and the 0-2 pitch. And it's fouled away. Again, he sends it out of play. No score here as we play inning number 2. Still no balls and 2 strikes.
Oh my goodness.
Swing and a ball hit out toward right center. Hopper on the move. He tracks it down and makes the play to record the second out.
That exists.
No contact on the sinker there, and he's behind 0-1. Still looking for our first hit in the ballgame. Strike 2. That fastball was a lively one. You could hear the pop of the glove all the way up here.
Yeah, nothing.
A swing and a miss. That retires the side, and that will do it. So nothing happening this time around. Now to the plate, Barney Rhodes. He'll step in to lead it off in the top of the third. High and tight here to begin the inning. It's ball 1. Fastball got him to swing through it. It's 1-1. Rhodes is a guy that has a lot of speed, no doubt about that. And while that's certainly a weapon for him offensively, it could be argued that it benefits him just as much on the defensive side of the ball, given the position he plays. Into the corner and slicing foul.
Batter's going to have to find a way to regroup right there. That caught too much of the plate. He knew it. He missed it. He might not get another opportunity to put the ball in play.
Now a swing and a miss as he picks up another one. Make it 4 strikeouts already, and there's your first out.
It's always nice to keep a guy that has good wheels off base, and that's just what they did right there. Big strikeout, you keep that guy off the base path.
Jeremy Hawkins is in with 1 away now as he swings and misses here at strike 1. In into the windup. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Pitch sharply, but foul down the right side.
Oh.
Third inning, no score to this point. And he struck him out as well. So the bottom of the order providing little resistance here, and there are two away.
Man, they really had his number so far in this series. That's his fifth strikeout in this series alone.
Starts him out with a slider for a strike. There's the fastball that gets the lower part of the zone called for a strike. Sinker misses, and it's 1-2 now. Struck him out, so he makes quick work of him here. Three straight strikeouts, and the side is retired. Ready now, Domingo Zepeda. He's 0-1 thus far. And here's a fastball called for strike one.
You can tell this offense is getting frustrated. But this might be one you have to shower off. When a guy's locating like this, fastball at the knees and to both corners, it's going to be tough for them to do anything with it.
Now a ball lined to the left side, but foul. The next 0-2. Misses for ball one.
Two strikes.
Swing and a miss on the fastball, and that's the first out.
Boy, this guy has really good stuff so far on this one. How about 7 Ks, and we're just in the middle innings of this one. If he continues this up, this could be a real solid performance.
Ben Gamel will stand in for a second time here as he swings and misses there. It's nothing and one. Oh, and he's really getting the better of him now. It's strike two.
Man, when you're struggling at the plate, that pitcher smells blood in the water. He's coming right after you, trying to end it quick.
And he struck him out. Strikeout number 8 now in the ballgame for him.
Pretty impressive. Back-to-back strikeouts to start the inning. What's even more important is now he gets to face the middle of the order without anybody on base for them to drive in.
Now back.
Standing in, Robert White. He got called out on strikes his last time through.
Yeah, in today's game, certainly don't get completely reprimanded for too many strikeouts, but no one likes to go down looking. Expect him to be a little bit more aggressive at the dish this AB.
A ball and a strike now. It's swung on and hit in the air toward the line in right. Hopper will reach out with one hand to make the catch on the move, and that ends the inning. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, number 12, 0-1 for him here in this one.
We're moving through the middle of this ballgame right now. They want to get things going. How about trying to get some base runners on or at least get a base hit? They don't have any hits going into this part of the game.
And he'll put this one away for the first out of the inning. Here comes the first pitch.
The batter, number 13.
And this one runs up high.
Too high.
These guys have got to be frustrated as an offensive unit so far in this one. They haven't been able to crack the code on their opponent, but it's not like they're getting great pitches to hit either. This starter has kept the ball on the corners of the zone all game long.
Get the target, but this is low, 2-1. Ball even at 2-2. One out, nobody on. And he rings up another one, making 9 strikeouts for him in the game. Digging in the switch hitter, Eddie Mathiasen. He looked to bounce back after striking out his last time up.
Yeah, he didn't put up much of a fight either, Matty. Gotta find a way. Can't go down 3 pitches. I don't care if you're staring at him or swinging at him. You have to find a way to make this pitcher work a little bit harder. Yeah, Matty, he's had these guys on a proverbial rocking horse all night. Changing speeds, hitting every quadrant. He's tough to hit.
That's how I am.
Again, another foul ball.
What a catch!
He brings this one back in. He took that right out of the first row. Wow! In now, Barney Rose.
This game is rolling right along as we move.
Oh my goodness, nothing.
You'd think by now one of these two teams would be able to get some base runners.
Pitcher's
on
duel.
That hasn't been the case.
For you, for you. What a catch by me.
Out of the inning.
I got this. I don't need help.
Into the box now, Jeremy Hawkins comes into this at bat 0-for-1 in the ball game. Hit in the air after
catch it, please do not drop it.
And quickly two or done now here in the visitor's half of the sixth.
But not for them, for us.
Yeah.
Stepping up now, Reggie Humphries. Right back to him on the mound. And they'll toss this one on to first as they're kept off the scoreboard again, and the inning is over. Now back to the top of the lineup, stepping in, Domingo Zepeda.
The seventh,
and Dan, as a former pitcher yourself, you must be enjoying this. Lots of good pitching and defense today.
Oh, that's one of the keys. We're seeing a lot of strikes. We're seeing a lot of swings. We're seeing some great
plays
on defense. This has been a snappy one up to this point.
The 1-1 home is in there for the second strike. The 1-2. Popped him up.
Go get it.
Number 9 has room in foul territory, but this will land untouched.
Damn.
Again, a 1-2. Still 1-2.
Gotta use a different pitch there.
Hey, he's got 4 foul balls in this AB right here. He's really making his pitcher grind for everything.
Got him.
And he strikes him out here. So that's out number 1 here in the 7th as he continues to keep him out of the hit column.
Some guys with big arms like this, they're just chuckers. They just throw the ball as hard as they can, and where it ends up isn't that big of a concern, but that wasn't the case there. That was a very well-pitched fastball right on the corner at the knees. Good luck getting that one.
1-1-1. A bouncer up the middle. And
really?
A base hit. So the perfect game bid ends in the 7th.
Friggin' moron.
They finally break through for their first hit of the ball game, so the no-hit bid will end right here.
Yeah, Matty V, this is what you start thinking about that.
Off.
No, you get into the 7th inning, D-Row. As a pitcher, you start looking ahead to what might happen.
And that fan, the throw to first is there. The inning is over. Add another
on,
zero as it's up.
There you go. Somebody has 4.
So digging in now, number 12. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into the later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
That one catches the edge of the zone, called a strike. 1-2.
I'll tell you, we're in the later stages of this ball game, but his fastball is still coming out of his hand with plenty on it.
Out in front here is this one scorched foul to the left. The 1-2 is a fastball that misses.
And it's late his afternoon of work, and the longer this at bat goes, the better a chance of him making a mistake. But as a guy starts to tire, they're more likely to leave the ball up. But man, he's been good so far.
What the hell are you doing, bro?
Pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he's safe at first. He's set and the bench.
Number 13.
And they start him out away with a cold strike.
All right, all you're asking for as an offense is a chance. Well, your leadoff man has certainly done his part. He's gotten on base. You have to start clawing back into this game right now. You're going to find a way.
And that's through for his first base hit in this one.
Hey, this might be their best opportunity to at least get on the board. They've been struggling offensively, and they find themselves with 2 runners on board. Let's see if they can continue.
How about it? The first baseman.
He's ready. Here's the first offering. And a fastball's in there for strike 1.
You know, Matty, when I first broke into the league, you wouldn't see that high heater first pitch right out of the gate. But I think there's been a change in philosophy here. Back in the late 90s, early 2000s, guys wanted to attack you more east-west, get you leaning left-right. Now you're seeing guys attack in the philosophy more north-south. Just with launch angles and velocities, I think guys are afraid to throw that sinky fastball for fear they don't
hit the spot.
Well, this one had its moments of drama and excitement. In the end,
but they went and give away 3 runs.
Five 5-3 in a final left score me in, the damn in this game. Afternoon's game. Las Vegas jumped ahead in the seventh inning and never gave the lead back. Ace Lyles takes the win on the mound, his second of the year.
I could have got out of the inning. He went and go pull out me out of the game. Ooh, me. Alright, guys, I want to thank you guys for watching. MLB The Road to the Show 19 on the PlayStation 4. And like and subscribe. And also don't forget to press the notification bell to let you know when I upload. And see you guys next time. Bye, guys!